Hey, this is Coach Andre. Today on Swim Like Me, we are going to be discussing the impact and importance of having someone who looks like you in the water.
Okay. At the time when I was younger, running track and field and swimming, I chose track and field more so because of the social aspect. I mean, there was a lot more people that, you know, looked like me there. And even though that wasn't a big hang up with swimming, but it was enough of one. One thing, the opportunity that I had, if I would have went to a team in high school, I didn't really like the coach that was there. So I said, well, one thing, there's nobody here that really looks like me. Mm-hmm. And then two, if this coach isn't really treating me in a way that I feel is respectful, I'm definitely not messing with this. Had the coach been, because my parents, they put us in a program at a summer program at a university school when we were younger. And I like that coach. Possibly, had I had that coach, I would have been able to overlook, I think, the aspect that there were really nobody that looked like me. So that the person who's in charge has to be, I would say, very supportive. And, you know, that's kind of what kept me from going further with my swimming at that age. You know, it was just more that I liked track and field. I know I wasn't the best at it, but it was, I did my thing. But, you know, the people that are around, you know, they look like me. I could relate really easily. I could not so much with swimming. And then some of the people that I knew that were on the team, you know, I knew that there were some people, certain people that I would have to, you know, didn't care for too much. You know, not all of them, but the ones that I knew would have been a problem, I said, I don't feel like having to deal with that kind of those little racial issues if I don't have to. I'll just go with something that I like to do. But if the coach, I would say if the coach that taught our AAU swim team, if that was the coach, because he wouldn't have tolerated none of that, you know, crap, that discrimination stuff that a lot of people go through. Mm-hmm. I probably would have went with the swim.
How important for the other panel members is it to you to have a coach that looks like you?
Extremely important. It might have been around this time of year, and I'm sitting home watching something on TV, and a commercial comes on talking about swimming. And I'm looking at this black man something, and I'm just looking, trying to jot down whatever the program is. Okay, forget about what I'm watching. I'm waiting for the next commercial to come on to find out who this is. So, didn't get the full name. So I'm on the computer. Okay, stroke something, stroke. And they're giving me stroke symptoms, stroke. Okay, and then I'm Googling black coach, black swimming coach, black. I just could not catch up with who this was because I wanted somebody who looked like me, where I might have the support and encouragement to do the thing I thought I couldn't do. So to me, critical, absolutely critical.
And I think it's important also because I remember when Andre and Antoine, and this, it didn't happen with the incident with swimming, but every year they went to a white school. So every year I made them be a black character during Black History Week. And so one year they said to me, we're not going to do that anymore. And I'm like, why? And they said, because it's not true. If it was true, it would be in the history books. And so I'm like, you know, and I have tried to give them all kind of exposure. But in their minds at that time, when they were younger, they thought if, you know, black people, all this stuff that you're saying about black people and what black people was happening, mm-hmm. if it really is true, then it would be in these books that we're reading in school. And there was none of that within them. Plus they said, and plus we never ever win because our costumes are not elaborate like the costumes that the white people had. Mm-hmm. And so we have, you know, jeans and all that kind of stuff. And I remember that for, you know, so I tried to give them more and more exposure so that they would understand it is true. This is what you're dealing with. And so that's the same thing with swimming. If you don't have somebody looking like you, mm-hmm. these young kids might, I don't want to do that.
Well, the availability piece, as Coach Andre mentioned, having a coach out of university school that was interested in developing all kids, regardless of race or color. And Coach Andre, well, he knows, it takes me back to when my father put me into, my brother and I, into University Circle YMCA. At that time was on 105th and Euclid. And we had programs there that addressed most sports. And there happened to be just one particular gentleman who came from Yale University to the YMCA and was recruiting youth at the Y to come learn how to swim. I was 6 years old at the time. And his name is Pete O'Dell. He's one of the most wonderful swimming coaches I've ever had in my life, Caucasian person. But I love what he did in giving us the proper exposure, the training, the conditioning, the human interest that he showed in us, and support and encouragement, and just the whole nine yards, as Coach is saying. You know, it's hard to find people like that in life, and we all know that. And that's an important piece. Like you were saying, how you pulled up the information. I mean, to see somebody like you that's talking, you know, the swimming,
yes,
talk and conversation, and say, well, you know what? I think I'm gonna get in there and try it. But if you don't see people like that, it can be, you know, a tough way to go.
My husband was excited about the opening of this rec center here. And he came home and told me about it. They have a really nice pool. You should go. You can do aqua aerobics. They have the classes. And I think there's a swim coach. He told me everything about this place and the coach, except that he was an African-American man. So, to my surprise and delight, when I saw a coach, I was like, is a black man teaching swimming?
I know.
What? I did not, I guess it's kind of naive to think that no one like you existed, but I was very happy to see that you did exist. And on that first conversation, I said, I've taken these lessons three times in my life and I've never been. He goes, you haven't had the right teacher, is what he said to me. And here I sit, able to swim from one end to the other. Thank you, coach.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, okay. Just to co-sign on what you said, like I said, I saw the TV commercial and that just said, okay, I'm signing up for whatever this was. I had to Google it, or maybe I saw the commercial again, I don't remember, but whatever it was, I signed up for it. But to fast forward, starting with the programs here at Tri-C, I come out of the locker room and I see women who look like me. They're in the pool. Okay, there's no water rescue, there are no paramedics, they're not flailing, you know, nobody's help. They're swimming, they look like they're enjoying themselves, they smile, they wave. You were at the end, and I'm telling you, the more I walked toward you and past them, whatever hesitation or anxiety was just falling away. Because if I could see people who look like me doing the thing I wanted to do, I'm like, I'm open and receptive to being taught, instructed, you know, to take part in. So it was the biggest factor in continuing to do it, to do this, and feeling like I could reach this goal. Very welcoming, supportive. It just felt right. And I think that's as big a factor as anything else.
That was a bonus.
Yeah, it was.
A bonus. Being determined to want to swim after however many years of being afraid of it, and then to find out your coach looks just like you and had some similar life experiences as yours and can speak your same language, and everybody, almost everybody around you, that it's just like, I've got a community over here. That was just a bonus for me.
I pretty much agree with everyone now. Linda Brooks, I don't know if you guys know her. She always talked about Coach Andre. You gotta go to Coach Andre. You gotta go. And I'm finally here, and I'm excited. It's amazing, okay? And again, to see people that look mm-hmm. like me and the coach that looks like me and understands, you know, what it is for somebody like me to not swim and fear of swimming. And then on the other aspect, I will say, I don't know if you guys experienced that, where people of color that don't swim yet say, that's for white people.
I've heard that.
And it's like, okay, no, it's not, you know? So we have to encourage other people that look like us to come out and mm-hmm. swim. If nothing else, for our health, it's gonna be fun, you know?
Yeah.
So I'm excited.
Say it loud.
Swim like me.